Welcome to the session on
computer
network.
In our previous session, we have discussed about the peer-to-peer networks, right? Peer-to-peer communication, I can say. And before that, we have discussed about the open system interconnection model, OSI model. And we have seen that we are having seven layers into the OSI model, and they are nothing but your physical layer and data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, and application layer. As I already told you people that your syllabus will be consisting of detailed information about all the layers in which you people will be handling your data communication. See, the first and foremost responsibilities of your physical layer has been discussed in this particular topic, so that you people will be having a clear idea what the physical layer is doing and how the responsibilities will be taken care by your physical layer. Physical layer is responsible for transmitting the data in the form of raw bits, I can say. This is a major responsibility of your physical layer. Means to say that whenever we are receiving the data from your data link layer will be handling the data in the form of what? Frames. But by your physical layer, data will be sent in a raw bits. Raw bits means these frames will be divided into raw bits like ones and zeros. This will be converted from your physical layer, and this physical layer will be transmitting the data into the raw bits. These raw bits will be sent from one system to other system through what? Transmission medium will be used in order to transmit all these data bits. So from system A, the system B will receive the data in the form of raw bits by using the physical layer. The design issues of the physical layer incorporate with the mechanical and electrical procedural interfaces along with the underlying physical medium, and it will be affecting by choosing the transmission medium that we are going to use and choosing the mechanism that we are going to use in order to transmit the data, and the electrical signal or as the optical signals that we are going to use in order to transmit those particular raw bits, that will be affecting your physical layer. How it is transmitting the data, that will be taken care by considering all these particular things, I can say. Okay, so you people might have understood what the physical layer is actually doing. Right, it will be transmitting the data from one system to other system by using the transmission medium via a transmission medium. Transmission medium can be anything. We'll be discussing what are the transmission mediums that we are having. Okay, and by using them, we will be transmitting all the raw bits, I can say, from one system to other system. And the major responsibilities of your physical layer is to transmit the data from one system to other system. But how it is transmitting? Is transmitting in the form of raw bits. Those raw bits will be encoded in zeros and ones, and they will be given in the form of electrical signals or optical signals. When you are transmitting the data in a wired manner, then they will be transmitted into electrical signals. If you are using optical fibers, then it will be considered into the optical signals. And how much electricity should be consumed in order to represent its raw bits like zeros and ones will be taken care by your physical layer, I can say. Right? In the physical layer, defining the characteristics of the interfaces will be done, which lies between the transmission medium and the physical layer. Whenever we are connecting with the transmission medium, it will be defining the characteristic of this particular transmission medium, whether we are using the twisted pair, whether we are using the optical wire, whatever the transmission medium that you are going to consider, those characteristics will be given by your physical layer. And it is also having the responsibilities of how many bits should be sent per second. Transmission rate, I can say, how many bits are sent from system A to system B, that is nothing but your transmission rate. How we are going to send from one system to other system, in what range we are sending that will be fall in the your transmission rate. And physical characteristics, as I said you people, transmission medium that you are going to use now, those characteristics will be defined by your physical layer. And synchronization, you see now, you people will not be having the same speed at the both end. when the receiver is slow, sometimes sender may be in a fast mode. Sometimes sender will be slow, but the receiver can receive in a faster manner. For example, consider system A is sending from system A to system B. System A is having 100 Mbps speed, but system B is having receiving speed as 10 Mbps only. Then they should be synchronized. They should not lose any data while transmitting the data. They should be synchronized. They will be synchronized by using physical medium, by using physical layer, I can say. How it will be done, that we will see. But the responsibility will be taken care by your physical layer. The sender and receiver class, both are not have the same bitrate. As I have taken the example, sometimes we will be having sender in a slower manner and receiver in a faster manner. Sometimes we will be having a slow receiver and fast sender. Okay, so such kind of situations will be handled by your physical layer. And I already told you people that what is the line configuration. This is the physical layer responsibility, that how we are going to connect the system. Whether we are going to connect the system in a point to point manner, or else whether we are going to connect the system in multi point manner. This line configuration I have already discussed, ma. That is the reason I am not discussing it in detail one by one. Already I have told you people what is the point to point configuration. Point to point configuration is nothing but when we are connecting two systems, when we are having a dedicated line towards these two systems, they will fall under point to point configuration. When we are having throughputs, when we are having many throughputs, if we are having multiple systems to be connected, then we will be using what? Multi point connection. They are nothing but your line configuration. See here, the physical layer is concerned with the connection of devices, how we are going to connect with other systems. Whether we are having a dedicated path, whether we are having multiple paths from the system, that will be taken care by your physical medium. Already I told you people, transmission mode. The transmission mode will also be fixed by your physical layer. How you are going to transmit the data, what kind of transmission mode that you are going to use, that will be taken care by your physical layer, I can say. Already we have discussed what is the transmission mode already, right? Transmission mode is a way of exchanging the information. How you are exchanging the information from one system to other system. And we have seen three kind of transmission modes, like simplex and half duplex and full duplex. I want to revise in a short manner. Simplex transmission mode will transmit the data in only one direction. If system A is sending the data to system B, then it will be done in only one direction. System B cannot send the data in other direction. It will be receiving the data. That's it. Example is your keyboard from monitor. You people can give the input from your keyboard to your system, but your system will not provide any signal to your keyboard. Okay. And half duplex is nothing but it is a way of two-way communication, but only one person is allowed to send a message at one time. Example is for walkie-talkie. If someone is talking on the walkie-talkie, other person should listen first, and when they are receiving the signal like over, then other person will see. Okay. And full duplex, already we have discussed, at the both side they can transmit the data. The best example is your telecommunication. Okay. In which mode we are transmitting the data, that will be taken care by your physical medium, or as physical layer, I can say, not medium, physical layer. Okay. Physical topology. See, what is the topology? It is a logical connection, I can say, how we are going to connect the systems in a logical manner, that we have seen in a topology. And which topology will be suitable for that particular kind of transmission, that will be taken care by your physical layer. And we have discussed all the topologies. I don't want to discuss it again. Okay, just I will revise the things that we have discussed in a topic called topologies. That is bus topology, mesh topology, star topology, ring topology, and hybrid topology. We have seen tree topology. All these kind of topologies that we have discussed in the previous sessions. Just go for them so that you people will be getting the physical topology. Okay. And see, in what way these things will be taken care by whom? Your physical layer. So in what way we need to select the topology, in what way we need to transmit the data, in what way we need to connect our systems, in what way we need to synchronize our systems so that the speed sender and slow receiver and slow receiver and speed sender can manage the data. And those all things will be taken care by your physical layer, I can say. This layer is responsible for transmitting the data in a more and more flexible manner, so that without having any loss, we could send the data from one system to other system. These are the functionalities as well as the responsibilities of your physical layer, I can say. See, as I told you people, it deals with the physical characteristics of medium. What medium that you are going to use? Transmission mediums are there, no? Coaxial cable, optical fibers, and twisted pair cables. What you are going to use and the whatever the characteristic that is given, they will be given to your physical layer and represents the data in the form of bits and how it should be represented in the form of zeros and ones. How much frequency should be taken, how much electricity is needed for representing zeros and ones. That will be taken care by your physical layer. And design issue mainly deals with the mechanical, electrical and timing interface. So already I told you people what we are going to do in this particular thing, transmission. That will be dealt by your physical layer and synchronization of bits. Already I told you people there will be an issue of speed sender and slow receiver and speed receiver and slow sender. Okay, those will be synchronized. And transmission techniques. Already I told you people how the transmission modes are used and what are the line configuration that we are going to use, whether it is a point to point, whether it is a multi point. Okay, and physical topology already we have discussed, and transmission mode also we have discussed. These are the major responsibilities of your physical medium, I can say. This is very 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 important, ma, while you are going for the computer network subject, I can say. If you are certified with the computer networks, you people will be having a good future onto this computer networks. Already I told you many times. I hope this physical layer responsibilities are very clear to you people. And that's it for now. See you in the next one. Thank you.